Well, Sam, thanks for joining us on Sandful TV to preview the 2024 Host Plus Sandful League season. How have you settled in back here at the Eagle's Nest?
Yeah, thanks, Zach. It's really exciting to be back here at Oval Avenue, and I guess when the opportunity came up and going through the process and all that, mate, it was really enjoyable coming back home to the Eagles. And I mean, it's somewhere I stayed in close contact with throughout my time in the AFL, but certainly nice to be back home in a formal capacity.
How would you describe your coaching style?
I'm definitely a people first, players first coach, and I think, you know, I'm only 35 and I'm relatively new out of the game, so I'd like to think that I can still connect with the current player, and definitely a relationships first coach.
Obviously here at Woodville, it's not very often the Eagles miss the major round, but did last year. What do you need to do to get back into the top five?
Yeah, it is odd. I think it's 23 out of 32 they've played finals or something like that. So it's a quite incredible record, and that brings expectation as well, which I'm looking forward to. But for me, number one, we just need to get a better players on the park. Obviously, the club got hit pretty heavy last year with injuries and all that, but we've had a really good pre-season, as I know everyone says that's this time of the year. But you know, for me, judging that is we're healthy and we've got a lot of our key players ready to go. So, you know, we implement some changes and some slight tweaks, but ultimately we just want to get the guys on the park and gelling together.
Only had the 6 wins last year, but if there was one that perhaps gives you a lot of hope coming into this season, it'd have to be the round 17 win against Glenelg here at Mourne Team Kia Oval, because you knocked off the eventual premier late in the year.
Yeah, it is, and that was, it's funny you say that was the first game I went back and had a look at. That and also the West Adelaide one is obviously stark contrast in 2 weeks, so I guess that probably summed up a bit of their season last year. But I'm quite confident in the top level players we got here. You know, their credentials speak for themselves, and I'm looking forward to bringing that next wave of generation coming through as well. And you know, 80% of our list is made up of pathway players, and that's something we're very proud of as a club, and something I'm looking forward to giving those guys an opportunity as well.
What have you gleaned from your trial matches through the summer?
I think, you know, our game's in pretty good shape. Over pre-season we did a lot of match simulation, and you know, with that you don't really know where you stand because you're playing against yourself. Obviously structures are all the same as well, but you know, we had a good hit out against South Adelaide down at Nolunga, and then out to the Doggies out at Central. So unfortunately we just come up a little bit short there, but there's a few reasons why. But you know, I think overall our game's in pretty good shape.
Tell us a little bit about Cam Fleeton coming over from GWS.
Yeah, Cam's one's I got a good recommendation from Phil Davis with that one, so a good contact. But yeah, Fleeto's a player we identified that role especially, and then his name obviously came up, and he's just, first of all, he's just a fantastic person, Fleeto, and he's a country boy from Geelong, and he really fits, I guess, what we're about as a club. So he's been a great addition. You know, his leadership's been great as well, and coming out of the AFL system, he's got some fantastic habits, and we're looking forward to, you know, if he doesn't get back up into the next year, to spending a lot of time at Oval Avenue.
The club's always been really good at welcoming back juniors out of the AFL system. Josh Morris comes back from Hawthorn. Where do you play him?
Yeah, it's always a bit unique, that, because it's disappointing to see guys come back, but it's really important that, you know, we do welcome them back with open arms, and that's certainly Josh, and it's been great for me just to get to know him, and he's obviously you know, a pretty electric player at times, but he'll start down back, and you know, he's good mates with Luke Beacon, Zane Williams and all these types, so you know, we think they can build some real synergy together, and I know he's looking forward to the season starting.
Tell us about James Rowe's pre-season and how's he tracking it? It's been an interesting one for him.
Yeah, it has. I guess it's a bit of a shock for Rowe as well, I guess, how much airtime that did get. And I think when you're a past Crows player, your dad works on the radio, that it comes with you know, a little bit of added outside noise. But he obviously had a tough period pre-Christmas, and from then though, he's been sort of hasn't missed a beat. So he's in good shape, Rowe. He's excited for the year, and he's certainly a player that loves footy season more than pre-season, I think.
Indeed. He'd be right for round one, do you think, or how's he tracking?
No, absolutely. No, he'll be cherry right for round one. Like I said, pre-Christmas it was a bit, you know, a bit wait and see, but ever since then, we eased him back, and he's been pretty solid since then.
When you went back and looked at those couple of games, you would have no doubt noticed some really exciting youngsters who already pushed up and played some league footy, but you must be really excited to work with guys like Cade Herbert, Jay Watson and Paddy Weckett.
Yeah, absolutely. Adam DeLoya, you know, the list goes on with those guys that are coming through as well. And like I said, Zach Buck, Sam Nichols, you know, we've got a lot of guys coming through that have come through our pathways and have played a lot of footy together. So absolutely, they're the ones I'm really excited to work with, along with our top tier guys as well. So the challenge for me is to, I guess get us all gelling together and bridging that gap between the older and the younger and, you know, putting our best foot forward.
Perhaps it might be one of those, but who else on the track that has really impressed you over summer might even bob up and get a Powerade breakthrough player nominee?
Yeah, we've got a few, I guess, that fit that criteria, and Will Newman's probably one as well. He's it's been really good to watch Will develop over pre-season, because he made a massive change in his off-season, and I guess the player that you know, we saw 12 months ago is different to the player we see now, the way, you know, he's prepared physically and all that sort of stuff. So he's setting himself up for a really good year. Adam DeLoy, as I mentioned before, he's a guy who just, you know, I think he seems like a player that's been around a lot, you know, former state underage captain and all that sort of stuff. He played 19 games in the midfield last year. Sometimes we forget how young he is. So I don't think he qualifies, unfortunately. But, you know, blokes like Cade Herbert, you know, these guys coming through, they're really going to complement the older guys.
Just had been fortunate to have a bit of a guided tour through the Airy here at Mourne Team Kia Oval. Tell us about what that's been like. Obviously, not ideal for you in terms of settling in, but it's going to be tip-top come the season because it's ready to go now.
Yeah, it's probably been a little bit shaky coming in to start, but I mean, I'm going to see the fruits of it. So the club's done a great job, and, you know, it's been in the works for, you know, quite some time now. And for us to come here and be in a, you know, new renovated facility, and obviously, you know, we're very fortunate here at Mourne Team Kia. The ground's always, you know, is one of the best in the league. So combine that with new facilities, we'd like to think it's, you know, it's going to be a really good experience for our players. And that's ultimately what we want. We just want to improve the experience that the players have here, and obviously the fans and supporters when they come here as well.
You get to test it out good and proper quite a bit early in the season with your first three at home here and four of your first six, so you can get on some real momentum if you chalk up the wins here.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, as weird as it sounds, it's home ground advantage is an advantage in the SANFL. Obviously, different parts of the city, but the ovals play slightly different. But no doubt, having games at home is going to be great early days, as, you know, you just feel a lot more comfortable in your own surround. So, it's a big challenge first up against one of my good mates, Adam Hartlett, and against West Adelaide this Friday. So it'll be good, and I'm looking forward to it.
Could we see a bit of banter on Twitter with that? Or?
Absolutely. I'm sure there'll be a banter pre-game as well. So, he's the male model of the coaching group, no doubt, Hart. So,
I look forward to it, Sauce. Thanks for your time on Sanford TV, and all the best for the 2024 Host Plus Sanford League season.
Thanks, Zach. Cheers, mate.